Hey there, boys and girls, my name is OTHMARiUS and welcome to my channel. Welcome back to the card table, that is, and today I want to show you how to shuffle cards with expert card technique seated at a table. Before we dive into the material, however, I want to tease you a bit with a Four Queens production. That's right, check it out. I've got in front of me these beautiful playing cards, them tally-hos. Now I shuffle them and I cut them, and then we should find, to our very surprise, that one of them cards comes popping out of the deck. And that's the Queen of Diamonds. This is good news, because with the Queen of Diamonds on the table, all I gotta do is tap and snap and the Queen of Spades comes flying. Now I think I should shuffle the cards one more time and even give them another card. Let's roll with this one. Let's see what this does. Here we go. And that's right, the Queen of Hearts comes jumping to the top. Now, to be honest, I lost track here right now, so I gotta do a little bit of peeking. That's peek number one. This is peek number two. I got it now, and there comes the missing queen. What do you mean? Can you examine the cards? Of course, I told you, this is an ordinary deck of cards, and those are the only four queens in play. What are you suggesting? That I'm cheating? OTHMARiUS MAGIC. Like and subscribe. Now I'm pretty sure some of you won't be able to focus on cards right now at all because of this. So I want you to know that I went full retard with a razor blade on my facial hair. I don't even know what that is, but I thought, why not shooting a video with it for the memory, you know? And also, I'm very excited walking the streets with this. Maybe in times of coronavirus, this helps keeping folks at a distance. Or maybe this even becomes my brand new style, you know? And then I put decorations on those, you know, bells or skulls or even diamonds. Before I show you how to perform the table riffle shuffle with expert card technique, please note, there are links in the info cards above as well, info box down below, for the tutorial series on the card productions I use in the intro performance, as well as for the tutorial on the simple table undercut, because we are using the same handling here, cutting the cards in half in order to riffle shuffle them. So the handling we use in the simple undercut is a requirement for the table riffle shuffle. So if you need to catch up on this one, please watch the tutorial. For everybody who already watched it, a little reminder here, we keep the inner section of the bases of our palms in contact with the table surface, in light contact with the table surface, and then we have our thumbs run parallel to the long sides. And from there, we cut the deck fairly in half, creating this V-shaped triangle pointing at us. And the beautiful thing about this handling here is that we don't have to re-grip from here. We can go immediately into the action of shuffling the cards. Our pinkies support and stabilize everything that's going on from the outer short sides, pretty much at the outer corners. The ring fingers and middle fingers rest at the long sides, and the indexes are curled inwards on top of the deck. The thumbs run parallel to the inner long side. Check this out. In this grip, the corner here fits perfectly into the lowest joint of the thumb, pretty much at the top of the base of the thumb. With the thumb, and I can stress this enough, with the thumb running parallel to the long side, covering about two-thirds of the cards. With both hands holding exactly the same grip, we now lift the inner long sides of the packages up until we can't go any further, unless we would tilt our wrists and therefore lift the palms of the hand from the table surface. But we don't want to do this. So we lift the packages from the inner long sides up until we can't get any further, except for bending them lightly against the knuckles of the index fingers. And now we have the tips of the thumbs roll over the edges of the cards, and therefore having them jump from the tips one by one, alternating right and left, and therefore riffle shuffling the cards. And of course, you start this slow before you speed things up. This handling, by the way, is a blend between the version of the shuffle displayed in Expert at the card table and the Royal Road to Card Magic, because Erdnase, an Expert at the card table, displays something like this, where the thumbs operate super close to the corners, the cards only get bent and then riffled from the corners here. Now this gives you a lot of control over the cards, but it's such a tight handling. And in the Royal Road to Card Magic, we find something like this, with the index fingers extended and the thumbs coming from the top. And I can't even do that. I wouldn't recommend this handling at all. It's no good. You don't get really control over the cards. However, it looks much fairer, you know, because you see what's going on. You know, you don't cover up the cards. So I was thinking, you know, what about, you know, taking the best of both worlds? So we keep the overall handling from Erdnase. However, we lift and bend the cards in this scenario while shuffling the cards. This gives us this fair look, but at the same time, we gain high control over the shuffle. I highly recommend practicing from the very beginning in the following manner. We break off the lower portion with our dominant hand. In my case, it's the right hand, right? We lift both packages from the long sides up. We bend them slightly against the index fingers. But now we start by riffling off 5 to 7 cards with our left hand, just like that, before the right hand joins into the shuffle. And then we make sure to have the last card coming from the right hand package. This generates a genuine shuffle, because we are shuffling cards from the center to the bottom of the deck, and we have a card from the center end up being top card. This is preparatory work for a beautiful false shuffling routine by Di Vernon, the professor. You might have heard of the guy. For now, we benefit of a gap here we create if we shuffle like that, which makes it so much easier picking up the right hand portion in order to push it into the other package, right? And again, we are not actually here changing the grip so much, but we are making use of our friendly pinky at the short sides, who helps us pushing the cards inwards. I like to push the cards on the diagonal. Is it the diagonal? This line here, you know, just like that, just to create this beautiful picture here of the cards going really into the packages, really interlacing, before I tilt my wrist and I align the packages before I square them up. And then you're ready to go into another round. So we break the packages apart, we lift them up, we bend them, we have our left hand drop a bunch of cards, the right hand joins in there, the right hand drops the last card, we push the cards in, we align them, we square them up, and we do the whole thing one more time. Turn the table riffle shuffle into a badass false shuffle with no effort at all. Again, we are cutting the deck in half in the usual manner. However, this time we keep the inner corners overlapping. When we lift the cards now at the inner long sides, we make sure to keep a bunch of cards resting at the tabletop from the right hand package as we immediately go into the shuffle. However, making sure that the last cards dropping this time come from the left hand package. This creates the illusion of a fair shuffle. However, the top and bottom stock remain untouched. This is what I used in the intro performance, with 2 queens at the top and 2 queens at the bottom. Just add some false cuts to the mix and you start killing it. Now, by the time of recording this, there are 8 folks supporting me with a pledge on Patreon, them so-called OTHMARiUS. Guys, thank you so much. You are rocking awesome. I said it before, I say it again. It means so much to me, and without your support, this wouldn't be going down. Thank you so much. Now, if you are new to the channel, and you enjoyed this watch, make sure to hit triple combo, like, subscribe and notification bell icon, and we'll meet again here at the card table pretty soon. Now get a deck of cards out if you don't have already, start practicing, practice, practice well, give it some time, and it will come to you. And in the meantime, rest assured, more magical stuff is going to be uploaded very soon.